In this episode, we talk about civil engineering versus architecture so you can decide the best major for you. What's up, everyone? This is Jake Voorhees, and you're watching episode 20 of the 1% Engineer Show. Make sure you guys subscribe to this channel so you don't miss out on future episodes about how you can be the best engineer you can be. This is a question that I've been getting a lot lately. I answered it on Quoria, I did a blog post about this, and it's a common thing that people are confused between architecture and engineering, or in this regard, civil engineering, because that's the one form of engineering that is most related to architecture. So that's really what this video is about. Architecture versus civil engineering. So when I say engineering, it really means civil. And I'm a civil engineer, so I can directly speak to this. As a global summary, although architects and engineers perform parallel functions in design, implementation of infrastructure, buildings, and things like this, they're actually very different. There's a big delineation between the two, and this video is going to tell you more about that so you know which one to choose, so you know which career path to go down, so you make sure that you are following your dreams and you can be a 1% engineer, or in this regard, 1% architect. But engineering is probably the way to go. So this video is going to give you four differences between the two so you can pick the right major for you. One, character traits. Architects and engineers often approach problems and situations from different foundations. Architects have a tendency to be more creative, think more outside the box, be more artistic, be more connected to the aesthetics of things. Whereas engineers have a tendency to be more quantitative, more numbers driven, more reasoning, rationale driven, instead of how they feel, instead of how it looks. Engineers want to know, how's this thing going to stand up? How's it going to be done? How much is it going to cost? It's all numbers driven with an engineer. There's a right type of person for each one. If you have a tendency to like to draw and be very creative and you have a colorful type of personality and way of thinking, then architecture is probably for you. Contrary to popular belief, there's actually tons of engineers out there who are very numbers driven, but they can't draw at all. They can do stick figures and free body diagrams for their classes. But in terms of thinking outside the box and being creative and actually being artsy, a lot of times these engineers struggle. And that way you know engineering is for you if you fall into this mold. Two, design. Engineers rely on equations, formulas, and scientific principles to solve problems, develop solutions, and conclusions to whatever they're working on in their field. Whereas architects have a tendency to consider the spatial functionality, the connection to its surroundings, how things integrate into aesthetics, and overall connectivity to neighboring entities, whether it be buildings or roadway facilities or functionality of a park or something like this. The approach to the overall design thinking is different between the two. Three, workflow. This is where architects have a big advantage. Because it comes down to feeling and energy and aesthetics and creativity and how it looks, architects typically are the starter for the planning. They are the ones that create the blueprints. They're the ones who have the vision for what we're going to build. And then the engineers take that vision, those blueprints, and say, okay, how are we going to do this? What's the most cost-effective approach for this? What is the right materials for this type of design? So again, if you want to be in the creative camp, if you want to be architecting these types of concepts, then you should probably go for architecture. Whereas if you want to calculate and actually crunch the numbers in a data-driven fashion behind what's going on, then engineering is for you. This is one reason why I became a transportation engineer and not a structural engineer, is because I knew if I went into bridges or buildings, it becomes quite cookie cutter most of the time. We already know how bridges stand. We already know how structures are going to maintain themselves in terms of their integrity. So when it comes to being free and the ability to do something a little bit different, we don't always need that in engineering. But in architecture, you're always trying to come up with some sort of different approach and be more creative. So that's one thing that engineering does actually lack. So in this regard, if you want to be trying to do things different and trying to deviate from the curve of whatever is going on in your city, your region, in terms of building trends and status quo, then the architects have a big leg up here. They typically are the visionaries behind what's going on, but they may not actually know how this thing is going to be built. That's where the engineers come into play. So there's a big difference in workflow in terms of planning. It starts with the architects and the engineers execute this vision that they have. Four, curriculum. And again, we're hitting on this same core principle where an architecture curriculum in university is typically going to be a little bit more artsy. It's going to be a little bit more theoretical. It's a little bit more about history. Because I was a civil engineer and I know that curriculum in and out, but I reviewed some architecture programs and it does have things like the history of society and history of architecture and design drawing and these types of things that engineers don't take. We barely had any breath requirements. At the University of Delaware, I could not take many courses beyond math, physics, and engineering courses that involve heavy, heavy, heavy mathematics. If you don't like math, then you definitely shouldn't be an engineer because I think I took something like three calculuses, three engineering maths, engineering statistics, and that's just the math courses. There was statics, structural analysis, structural design, concrete and steel design, geotechnical engineering, fluid mechanics. Some engineers have to take thermodynamics, which will destroy you, material science, which is math-driven. So math, 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 math. If you don't like math, if you don't like physics, if you can't tolerate a few chemistry courses, then you're not going to survive engineering. So maybe if math is a struggle for you, but you still want to be connected to designing buildings and infrastructure, and you have an architectural brain, then go for architecture. But people say this all the time, questions on YouTube, questions on Quora. Can I still be an engineer if I don't like math? Well, it's like, yeah, sure, maybe, but you're gonna definitely struggle. I like math a lot and I struggled myself, okay? So there's some big differences in the curriculum. Architects still have to take some math, but nowhere near as much as engineering courses. So those are the four core differences between architecture and engineering, guys. Character traits, design, workflow, and curriculum. Do me a big favor, guys. Hit the subscribe button so you can stay tuned in for more episodes. Thanks for watching the 1% Engineer Show, guys, and stay hungry on your quest to become a 1% engineer.